Here is one that I've been wanting to do for a very long time. Had a couple of half goes at it, and differing circumstances have led me to have to change my plans. But this time, we're going to try and give it a go. Obviously, you'll know straight away where we are. And once you see where we are, you'll also know the sun out that way. It's relatively early morning, and it is blowing a gale as per usual. What I am going to attempt to do today is get all the way through. I am attempting to go up to Wedge Island, Lancelin to Wedge. There's a solo mission again. The last legit day of holidays. 2020. Now, I do vaguely know the way to start off anyway, and I've watched a couple of vids last night just to see that I know what to look for. I used to think that you could get through here on all tracks, but the videos I was watching seem to make me think that it is actually quite a bit of the way you have to go on the beach, which I'm prepared for. The track's in there, obviously, and I have lowered my pressures beyond where I normally would. I'm sitting on 16 all around. I usually don't go quite that low, but I thought, well, nothing's stopping me this time. All the time in the world to do it. I need to go over this way. Get to the track that enters where I want to enter, where I believe I'm supposed to enter. So I'm just going to get across this way. And so far the tyres hold up brilliantly. Yeah, I'm not even noticing. Or we drive on a highway. It's not even dipping the engine roofs. So I think this 16 was a good call from the start. Now, this I believe will lead me to the track that gets to the starter hill. As I said earlier, absolutely blowing a gale out. Well, it's not a gale, but it's definitely blowing. And I would suggest that I'm the first one out here. Oh no, I couldn't possibly be the first one out here. That's not what I was going to suggest at all. I'm suggesting by the amount of tracks already on the laid down in front of me that there are people who have already done the run this morning, or started the run this morning, This gives me tracks to follow. There's a regulation water hole. Oh, I've got another idea. Why not throw it into four-wheel drive? Something crazy like that, eh? I'm only going four-wheel drive high because I believe that's going to be plenty. And turn off traction control. Beautiful. We're underway. Few people up here have had a bit of a struggle up this bit. It does look very soft. Following these tracks as much as I can, and my main plan is to get up to Wedge. From there, get there in reasonable time, might come back and have a play in the dunes. But first things first, this one's been on the bucket list for a while, so I'll make sure I tick off getting all the way to Wedge first. I think I have found the track before in the outback, and somehow, for the life of me, I cannot work out how. I've been a long way up this way in an old LC Tirana. How exactly, don't know. I've got a feeling the track I need is a bit further inland than this. This one's got marks on it, let's see where they go. Roo tracks, or a couple of emus and stuff on the way in. There might be emu tracks as well, actually. Right. If this goes straight over to the beach, I will be turning around. Oh no, it looks like it does. Keys connected, so I'll take them off at my earliest convenience. Let's get something slightly bigger in this path. This will do it. Right, keys off. Don't get that horrible bang bang clatter clatter. Just the choice of a harder track going over that little dune there. Maybe a track with more room in it. Going to the beach, it is, so I'm not going down that way. beach. So maybe doing a little turn around at this point, go for a further inland one. As I said, it is a Friday. There's still a lot of very fresh tracks on this. Fresh tire prints. So, this track, whatever it is, gets used a lot, which is good enough for me. I'm actually looking for that will lead me down to the beach, I believe, has fences either side of it. All the videos I was watching, none were made from this end. All the ones I saw started at Wedge and came back. So I'm winging it a little bit. It's like the eagle up there that you may have seen earlier. Just passing him now, just keeping the rabbit population down. Love tracks with those whoops in them. Just fun. Apparently they can heat your suspension up a fair bit if you on tracks with them for kilometres on end. You just be wary of that. But, little day trips, you don't have to worry about it. Follow the thickest of the tracks. Lots of little converging tracks here. Oh, okay, right. When I was watching some of the DVDs last night, I saw a few of these corners. They seem much wider out on one side. And I was thinking that there must have been limestone outcrops there that you couldn't see in the visions, but now I believe that they are tracks around the worst of these whoops, potentially. Not that they're terribly bad, but some people don't like them as much as me. These aren't too bad. I've had much worse. Some tracks around Durium Bay. Well, there were 30 years ago anyway. And they had much bigger whoops than this again in my good old LC Tirana, which I don't know why I was taking that out on sand tracks, but it coped. Okay, I expect I've still got quite a way to go on this track. So after these next whoops, I'm going to slow down into that flat bit. And I'll come pick you up again later. I'm sure there'll be plenty for us to see.